It is time for Package from China. Welcome to the YouTube channel Wicked Gamer and Collector. Welcome back, Wicked Family. I have something pretty damn awesome to show you today. But before we're going to do this, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that little bell. Alright, what did I get? An awesome custom PSP with this battery and charger. But let's take a close look at the system itself. What are we going to get? But what comes in this set? It comes with a basic charger, not original from Sony. We're having here a knockoff battery, and it's not the best I have seen. Why? For a little demonstration, it doesn't fit very well. The battery is freaking horrible. I hope the seller is not selling this battery with every system, so this is going to be a problem. It comes in a white little basic box, but I can tell you already, it was packed up very well. All right, the system itself, it's an original Sony PSP. So the, yeah, let's say the main board, everything is like the original system. So that's not a knockoff, but you can buy them with custom firmware. And this one even got some very nice blue crystal clear, yeah, casing. I really love it. I always want to have one, so I'm very pleased to have it. It also includes a little 4 GB of storage, not very big. I cannot understand why he didn't add 8 GB or at least 16 GB. And the main reason is there is an AMD drive here inside, but it doesn't work. I tried it, but no, like the seller was telling on the page on AliExpress, it is not working indeed. Nevertheless, it comes with custom software, so we can add our own games. What I really like to point out, that is something that I find is really annoying sometimes. The D-pad, as you can see here, if you push it very hard, it works. It works just fine. But when you press it very gentle, sometimes, as you can see, it doesn't respond. So there's a little bit of a bummer. And another problem with the analog stick is sometimes it's get stuck like this. So maybe you can fix it with some lubricant, but it's not, of course, like it should be. So I think the problem is with this because the casing itself is not original from Sony. Another small problem that I found out, sometimes when you want to power on or off or just want to close the system, or I'm doing something wrong, but as you can see, the button is not responding very well every time. So it can be a problem. So when you're powering on the system, it doesn't come install with games, so you need to add them yourself. So keep that one in mind. It's running on the latest, or so far I know, the latest software for the PSP, the homebrew software. So that is really awesome. All right, let's play some games. Need to remind myself that I need to press it very hard. Joystick works perfectly. If it doesn't get stuck. Get ready, fighters. All right, let's try it. The D-pad.
Hey,
The Metal Slug Collection for the PSP. Wow, what epic collection. Alright, let's skip. Skip, skip, skip. Cool, you can choose your Metal Slug, let's see. What do we have more? Even Metal Slug 6. Let's play the classic one. I can play in host mode. Oh, that's really awesome. Oh yeah. Have a machine gun. Use the analog stick. Oh, dude, shut up. And of course, here we can play some old Sega games. Everything works fine. Volume control. Brightness control. I want to point out, not all of the emulators are working perfectly on the PSP so far, I know. Of course, Nintendo 64 is not perfect, but... I know I need to press the buttons very hard on this PSP, but still it doesn't influence my gameplay. And I know I got hit by the monkey, who's throwing this coconut at me, but... It wasn't his fault! It wasn't his fault. Oh my god, I got some wicked gameplay here, people. And the PSP is famous for supporting PlayStation games. You only need to convert the original ISO or bin files to the eBoot files and you can play all of your favorite PlayStation games. And as you can see, the PlayStation or the PSP, sorry, PSP runs the PlayStation pretty damn good. And the reason I'm saying pretty damn good, did you hear it? I hear the little stuttering. Time for Super Mask. As you notice, sometimes I'm stopping moving because I need to press the freaking button very hard. The joystick doesn't do anything in this game. That was almost in the pit. Wait, seriously. Go away. And what I also love about the homebrew community on the PSP, we have some old school games like Commander Keen. This is what some call an old school game. Yeah, somebody outside is cutting down a tree. Yeah, it's just great when you're making a movie and somebody's cutting down a tree. So for the final conclusion about the custom PSP or refurbished PSP from China. I don't know if these problems are common or with every system. It's a little bit of a bummer of the analog stick and the D-pad, and this weird thing that's going on with the switch of the power. It's a little bit of a bummer. I really love what he's doing over there. These things are not very expensive, and a lot of people were telling me, why do you buy all of those knockoff portable systems from China? Because the PSP can do a lot of these things, like emulation and playing PS1 games. So yeah, that's also a reason why I wanted to make this video. So that concludes this video. I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell. And let me know what you think of this. I'd really love to know. See you next video.